5 factorial to the 5th was 24 billion. And if we assume we have a 2.4 gigahertz computer, which is fairly typical, then if all this could be compiled into one computer instruction, then it would take 10 seconds. But of course, that's ridiculous. You can't do all of that in one instruction. If it was 100 instructions, then that would mean it would be 1,000 seconds, which is about 16 minutes. But that seems too little. It's probably going to be more like 1,000 instructions to make all the way through doing all this and then checking the constraints. And so that would be about 160 minutes. And so an hour, 2, 3 hours, you know, maybe we say 2 or 3 hours, somewhere in there. It might be as little as 1 hour. We can't really tell because it's just an estimate. But it's definitely going to be in the hour range and not in the minutes or day range. Now, in fact, I actually ran this program, and we'll come back later and see how well this estimate of somewhere in there worked out. Let me just say, because we've learned that this will take somewhere in the range of an hour, don't try to run it here in the browser by hitting the run button, because we time out the calculations after just a few seconds. So it's not going to work here. You could type it into your own computer if you have Python running on your own computer, set it going, and see how it works. But first, we have to figure out how to do all the constraints. So we already did constraint number 1, which was houses equals 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now let's do constraint number 2, which is that the Englishman lives in the red house. And we want to write some if statement to check if the Englishman lives in the red house. And if so, we go on. If not, we give up. And so how do we check if it's true that the Englishman lives in the red house? So if, and then I want you to fill in some expression here. And we'll just say that this is constraint number 2. So tell me what you could put in here.